जय हिंद डियर स्टूडेंट्स, लेट अस स्टार्ट अवर टुडेज टॉपिक। एंड टुडेज टॉपिक एज यू नो इज सेल्फ वॉक। सेल्फ वॉक, एज द नेम इंडिकेट्स, वॉक इट मेक्स अ क्लियर कट इमेज इन योर माइंड, अ लेयर, अ बाउंड्री आउटसाइड विच प्रोटेक्ट्स फ्रॉम द सराउंडिंग। For example, there are various walls in our buildings, in our houses. These walls not only protect us from surrounding wild animals, infections, insects, etc., but also protects us from the environment or the climatic condition. In the same way, this wall, the word cell wall, indicates the wall which is present around a cell. And definitely, its function is to protect the cell from the surrounding circumstances. It may be the invaders, enemies, other infections, or it may be the climatic conditions such as wind, temperature, etc. Now, what is this? Where is this present? So, this cell wall is a significant characteristic of plant cell. Plant cell. This cell wall is the characteristics of a plant cell as a cell wall. Besides plant cell, there are some other animals such as bacteria. Some fungi, a few protozoa, some protists, etc. also have the cell wall. That means, however, this cell wall is the characteristics of plant cell. Besides plant cell, these organisms, some of these organisms also have cell wall. They are some bacteria, some fungi, some protozoa, and some protists, etc. Now we will start discussion with the plant cell. Now if you see here, this is a typical structure of plant cell. This is the structure which I will discuss later on. It is a dissection of single cell. This is a series of cells. These all are cells. Got it? These all are cells of a plant. These all are cells of a plant, and you see these are cells. These are cells of a plant, and this outer layer provided in each of the cells is the plant cell. Oh, sorry, it is the cell wall. This outer covering is the cell wall of the plant. Now, if you see, each plant cell is connected in a series, because the plants are very tall and they have a straight stem. So, these cells are connected side by side in a longitudinal way to give a structure. These cell walls not only they protect the plant from the climatic conditions or the animals, but also it provides a strength so that the plant can stand proper or give a structure to it. This cell wall is made up of cellulose. And you know very well, cellulose is nothing but the long chain of glucose. So this cellulose is a long chain of glucose, and definitely cellulose is the component which is not digested by animals or human beings. Especially some ruminants, they can digest, otherwise animals cannot digest cellulose. So this plant cell is mainly made up of cellulose, which is nothing but a long chain of glucose. But this one over the another connection or arrangement of plant cells is called plasmodesmata. Plasmodesmata, this word is not new to you because I have already discussed or mentioned this word plasmodesmata. Plasmodesmata. Got it? This structure, one over the other. There are some perforations. Got it? Okay, let me discuss this. Now, one cell is attached to another cell with a cementing material. Suppose in a wall, this is a brick and this is another brick over a brick. Again, this is a brick. In this way, we used to make wall of our houses. But to adhere, to keep two bricks together, we use some material, that is cement, sand, water, etc. Is it or not? In the same way, two or more cells to form plasmodesmata, they are connected to each other by a cementing material which is called middle lamina. This cementing material is present between two cells called middle lamina. Is it clear? So the connection, the arrangement of one cell longitudinally with another, suppose this is one cell, this is another cell, there is third, and likewise. This arrangement is called plasmodesmata, and the material which keeps the two cells together or the cementing material between two cells is called middle lamina. The cell wall is made up of cellulose, which is nothing but a long chain of glucose. Now we will move to the single cell, the structure of a single cell. Here you can see this is the structure of a single cell. These are the adjacent cells. Okay. Here, if we elaborate the figure, there will be another cell, here there is another cell. If you remember a football, then you will compare the structure of football with that of a cell. The football have several small patches, each connected to one another. In the same way, we are discussing about one patch. Suppose we are discussing about one patch. This is one patch. This one cell, from here, another cell starts. This is another. These are all another cells, and they are connected here by each other. Now, this is, if you see properly and if you are able to see, this is the cell wall, and this cell wall is made up of pectin, magnesium pectate, and calcium. This cell wall is made up of pectin, magnesium pectate, and calcium. This cell wall is partially permeable. But that means there is some permeability in there. Even though it is rigid and elastic, it has some degree of permeability.